I don't think we can overemphasize accessing, departing, hiding blinds, hiding your hunting approach more than we have. We seemingly do it all the time, but it really is that critical, because in this case where we have a food plot, we have good open access where deer can find us if we don't access at the right time of the day, right opportunity, right winds. And if we do that, we could spoil this whole feeding area out here in these open fields and ruin that afternoon movement. So what we're doing here, Egyptian wheat screening a food plot in this location right here. This Egyptian wheat is coming up. It's coming up really strong. It's about going to be about 12 to 15 feet wide. And we're going to put a blind about in this location. What I like about this is it's very steep going downhill. So when we access this in the afternoon, it's probably not going to be a morning spot. We don't know where the deer are out in these fields. We come in the morning, we're going to spook them. But we'd access it in the afternoon. All the deer that are bedded up in these hills, we won't spook. We can stay hidden right here. We'll come up to a wall of Egyptian wheat that's going to be 8, 10, 12 feet high. That blind will be within that Egyptian wheat. We'll add this blind when the Egyptian wheat's about 4 to 5, 6 feet tall. We're going to add a fabric blind so we can hide it within it while it's growing. So we have great access into this. We won't even be able to see the food plot until we get into the blind, look out the windows. And then what we've done is this food plot's about 100 yards long. It's stripping right from here, north to south. And while we're in the blind, letting our wind settle back off this steep face, the majority of the deer move through this bench system anyways. We've added food, made it very lengthy for about 100 yards. The deer will travel through here, and we want to make sure they keep traveling through there. Again, they're coming up here from their bedding areas. We want them to travel through here, and then we're sticking a water hole on that wood line over there. Now we have a stand location on the wood line because we can hunt that with different winds. So this whole system of movement right here, deer coming out of the hills, going through the food plot to the water hole. We're accessing non-invasively. We're getting into the blind. The blind's hidden. We'll poke a couple holes out where we can shoot into this little food plot. It's only about 30 yards across. Now when it gets dark, we need to get out of here. All the deer are this way because they've come from here, gone that way. So now we can depart to the south, go up to the wood line. We'll have to walk all the way around this lower field area. The deer are going to be in this lower field area. This is where they come every night. We can watch them during the summer doing that. It's early season pattern. And between this system right here and the same exact system over here, and then a couple stands up here that we can hunt cruising bucks out of, a couple stands down here out of the water holes, we have a system on this 40 acres without a lot of cover that we can hunt multiple stand locations and blind locations non-invasively. We want to protect that afternoon food movement. It's highly important. If we spook these deer out once or twice, they're not coming out in these fields during the daylight hours. We expect to keep from making these nocturnal movements all season long. We expect daylight movement every single afternoon. We want to preserve that. We're going to have some great hunting out of these 5 or 6 locations, including these blinds. Blinds are pretty tough. They're on the ground. But if you follow great access, hidden blinds, watching a very defined movement that has a purpose, coming out of bedding, through food, to water, to an evening destination field down behind us 300 yards, then if you follow those kind of steps within your planning for your blinds, more often than not, you're going to be able to get in and out of your blinds without spooking deer. And that's probably the number one priority that you can place on your property and your hunting this year, whether you're getting into a tree stand, a blind, watching a food source, watching a cruising area out in the woods. If you can get in and out non-invasively, hide your wind when you're in the blind or in on stand, then you're going to make a very small footprint getting in and out of your property. You're going to preserve your property, and you're going to have great hunting this season.